pro ref. One of our goals when we're making stuff is like to make the ultimate Halloween prop. We don't want a scarecrow, we want the scarecrow. We want the star of the film. So in this box comes the stand, Mr. Scarecrow's head, and the legs are very tall and skinny. This is his little friend, Corvus. Isn't he cute? I want you to see that eye. So the nice thing about this, besides his fingers being mobile, you can raise his arms, you can bend his arms. This is Frankenstein's experiment. Now we designed this around Mary Shelley's original Frankenstein script. And she described kind of this yellowy flesh, or just kind of yellowy green, and then gray eyes, black hair, very tall, and this is what he does. So Tom, you know, a giant rat. I can see this in a lot of places, like, oh, just a creepy old, like, well, like some biohazard, apocalyptic thing, zombies that affected the humans, made the rats grow big. Where else could you use it?
You know, you could have it in a pumpkin patch eating pumpkins. You can throw any number of Distortions corpses in front of it and it looks like he's eating the corpse. You can have it in a jungle theme. The real life counterparts may be cute and a little more friendly. You know, we're talking the difference between a Chihuahua and Cujo for this thing.
This is the Scarewolf legend. So your scarewolf's arrived. Let's get him out of the box. Just get this poles lined up and put him right in like that. And down he goes. Then just extend the arms, but also so you can bring those arms and do whatever you want. These can be bent, you know, that's a little too much probably. But anyway, it gives you a lot of control whether he's back, high, down.
I've been wanting to do her for 2 or 3 years.
And so, Jordu sculpted this. He's so good with anatomy and things.
So there's kind of background moaning, background screaming,
lightning, yeah.
Right. And then when she's activated, she rises.
And then she rises up, but she looks like she has a normal face. But in actuality, she's got this giant mouth sculpted to her chest. And her head just tips back and just this crazy mouth. We were talking about bringing back another spider because we talked about it a couple years, hadn't done it. And then you drew some and it was looking good, but then you drew this.
Yeah.
And it was so weird. I mean, I loved it instantly. And Marcia loved it too.
You know, we've kind of proved that there is a place for sci-fi in the haunt world.
And he's got a little extra set of teeth there. That was so cool. But it's just a really creepy thing. You can hang it and put it on the floor. These can elevate him as well as this bend. And you just get him right where you want him. The nice thing about these props is, first of all, they're made with natural latex rubbers, very, very strong. And then they're filled with polyurethane foam, which is spongy, but really strong.
Back it up. That's good. Hey, back up. That's good. Hey, stand down. Hey, good, that's good. Back up, stand
I think so.
Oh no.
It's a good thing I sculpt right-handed.
Different versions. This is the Raptor, and it's the animatronic version. This is Raptor Attack, and he jumps out at you in addition to moving. Calm down, it's all right. Dinner was just a little late. This is the announcement for the reintroduction of the original Giger's Alien from the film Alien.
Distortions Unlimited is collaborating with HalloweenCostumes.com.
And it took all of us to bring the most amazing movie monster back to life. And the fact that it's from the original mold is why I'm so excited about this launch. And doing it with the best people in the United States. You needed the masters to be able to bring something like this back to life.
The master that this mask came off of was produced in the 80s.
But the original that we made was from the mold, and it's the way it was. This is all Giger's work. We had to clean it up a little and fix it where we could, but it is his sculpture fixed up for casting, and that was the important thing. This is his sculpture, and that's why it's so valuable, in my opinion.
And so we had the foam piece, but there were, because it was so old, there were pieces we had to correct, and you had brought in four different artists to perfect the pieces that were kind of deteriorating.
Yeah, so this had to be re-sculpted so it looked like the film.
Super difficult work, and being able to do that all under a licensed, officially licensed product as well. I think this is for the avid collector who's been wanting this forever. You know, we are rabid fans, and that's who we want to support. This is going to be very limited. We know this is it's a hard, hard product to make, and there's going to be limited product out there.
This is history. This is Giger. This is one of the game-changing movies of all time. So this is Invasion of the Saucermen. This was a movie that came out in 1956. And these guys were sculpted by Paul Blaisdell, and he did a phenomenal job. This is back in the day of classic movie monsters. The original was this kind of color. It was kind of an orangey flesh, and we were able to get the original molds for these guys. And so from Paul's widow. In fact, they had to carry the molds over their head because the bridge was out or something. It's quite a tale. But anyway, we also wanted to offer it in green because even though it was this color, the film was black and white. And so for all the publicity photos, this was the color they used. And it looks so cool, little green men. I mean, it just doesn't get any more classic than that. So we offer it in both colors. And there's quite a story that goes along with these guys. You can watch at the end, but these are available as a foam-filled, full-body character. They're quite a bit of work. And you can order it in the green or the orangey flesh. And it's also available just as a head bust with the bib. So you can get just the head. This historically has been one of the most sought-after collectibles in the business. We made them for a couple years, and that was it, and they have not been available since. But these are from the original molds. This is about as cool as it gets for sci-fi monsters. You know what the foundation of Distortions is?
Yeah.
Aliens.
Yes, he does, okay?
Oh, come here, my little lab rats.
Ryan's here. He'd love to meet you.
How are you doing, Dr. Quantum?
How am I doing? I'm a brain in a vat. not some chatty barkeeper. But since you're here, Ryan, tell me, are you brave enough to survive the abyss of madness, or will you be crying for your mummy?
He has a loaded backstory that says he's at a haunted asylum called the Abyss of Madness. Oh, okay. So that's where that came from. Gotcha.
We all want to sort of anthropomorphize him, but what he's really doing is he's looking at the correlation between what we're talking about and what his script is. And he's going, is this related to me, or is this some babble?
Apparently it is.
So he's
Let's
going to have
what
another
he's got to say.
So you finally realize that I'm more than a simple parrot repeating on command.
We have a new little character called Jitters, and he's a little scared, but I'd like to introduce you to him. Jitters, come on up. It's okay.
Aww, poor little Jitters, he's scared.
Poor
Jitters.
It's okay. Jitters, come on.
Come on, you're come on, Jitters. Jitters.
Yeah, yeah, it's
okay.
Come on.
Jitters,
come on.
Come on.
Yay! Yay. What do you guys think of Jitters?
Yeah, do you like him? He's
cute.
Super cute.
He's kind of your baby, isn't
he? Yeah, well, I keep having babies at Distortion.
He's so cute. Look at
Who do you see, Jitters?
That's Marcia.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello.
And that's Janine.
Hey.
And that's Mondo. He actually poured you and phoned you. And that's your daddy. Unfortunately,
you don't need to be scared of me.
It's Lorena. She's going to be shipping your new homes.
Yeah.
But they'll be there at Monster Day, trust me.
Yeah. Monster Day, August 17th, downtown Greeley. And Jitters will be there for sale. And you can buy them online starting on Monster Day. Not before.
Not before.